Hello my dear friends, welcome back to the channel, and this is your friend Dr. Suresh Shenvi. I hope that you are liking the current ongoing series on dental cements, and today we are discussing about zinc oxide eugenol cement. Zinc oxide eugenol cement is mostly popular as a temporary restoration, and it has its own special advantages and disadvantages which will be often asked in the exam. The main advantage being its ability to give a best biological seal, and the disadvantage being its irritating potential because of the eugenol. We'll try to learn more about the other properties, and I hope that you will continue watching this video so that you understand the topic better. In the market, zinc oxide eugenol cement is available in two forms, that is the powder liquid, and it is also available as the paste form for operative dentistry. Zinc oxide eugenol is classified into four categories, the type 1 being used for temporary cementation, the type 2 is used as a permanent cementation material, the type 3 was mostly made for temporary filling and as a base, the last type, that is the type 4, was mostly used was a liner. And I know at this point you may also ask me that why would somebody use zinc oxide eugenol cement as a liner when we have better materials like calcium hydroxide. We'll discuss about it in the properties. Let's discuss the composition of the cement. The powder here too has zinc oxide as a major component. Please note, although you can obtain zinc oxide from various other materials, but generally it is obtained from heating zinc hydroxide. That's because when you get it from zinc hydroxide, the powder is found to be more reactive. Along with this, they have also added zinc acetate and zinc propionate to accelerate the setting reaction. The liquid consists of mostly eugenol, which can react with the powder, and that reaction is possible because it has a benzene ring, and this benzene ring is reactive with the zinc oxide. However, eugenol can irritate or produce allergic reactions when it reacts with the skin proteins, and that's why it is often replaced by oil of clove, which consists of 70 to 85% of eugenol but has less potential to cause irritation. Although the liquid also contains glycerin or glycol as retarders for the setting reaction, but it's the water from the liquid which has a major role on the setting reaction, and let's understand about it in the setting reaction segment. This cement also sets because of acid-base reaction, and the powder is basic and eugenol is acidic in nature. But please note that zinc oxide cannot directly react with eugenol. It has to be first converted to zinc hydroxide. And to convert zinc oxide to zinc hydroxide, it needs water or acetic acid. And acetic acid is better for this reaction. Once the zinc hydroxide is formed, this cannot act with eugenol. For this reaction too, we need water. And when you have water, the zinc hydroxide will react with eugenol and form a chelate called as zinc eugenolate and release the water as a byproduct. So if you see the setting reaction, we need water to initiate the reaction, and we also get water as a byproduct. And this water will again initiate the reaction. That's why this reaction is called as autocatalytic. Let's discuss about the properties of the zinc oxide eugenol cement. As discussed in my pulp capping video, we need three things for progression of caries. One is the tooth, second is the organism, third is the substrate or a food. And when you use zinc oxide eugenol as a temporary material for indirect pulp capping, it is found to have a very good initial seal to prevent the nutrients from reaching the organism. And also, since eugenol is constantly released from the cement in the deeper portion, it has found to have good antimicrobial property. So in this triad, we are cutting down the nutrient and the organism. That's why the caries will stop progressing. However, this was also used initially as a pulp capping agent in direct pulp capping, but since it doesn't have ability to stimulate the reparative dentin formation, it was soon discontinued once the calcium hydroxide became popular. Also note, in a deeper cavity where there is limited amount of remaining dentinal thickness, this zinc oxide eugenol can be really beneficial for two reasons. First being its pH, that is 7, and it is considered as a neutral. That's why it is far beneficial for the pulp in contrast to the other cements like glass ionomer or zinc phosphate or zinc polycarboxylate, since they have a lower pH. And the second advantage is its obtundant property on the pulp, When it is given in a deeper cavities, it is slowly releasing a very low concentration of eugenol, which will pass through the dentinal tubule and reach the pulp, and it will try to suppress the inflammatory mediators like the prostaglandins. And that's why this was very popular in the olden days for treatment of reversible pulpitis, where the main aim was to reduce the inflammation of the pulp. If you compare the solubility of cements in the oral cavity, zinc oxide eugenol cement is the most soluble out of all the cements which is used in dentistry. The other disadvantage being that it doesn't have any fluoride releasing property, that's why it doesn't possess any anti-karyogenic effect. The bonding too is not special, it doesn't have any chemical or micromechanical bonding, it has just mechanical retention into the cavity preparation. Although the strength of the zinc oxide eugenol cement can range from 3 MPa to 55 MPa, but since it is mostly used as a temporary material, the strength should be around 35 MPa so that you can remove it while doing a permanent restoration. However, zinc oxide eugenol cement also has negative effect on composite restoration. The first situation is where you give it as a base below composite restoration, and it is found that the zinc oxide eugenol will prevent the curing of composite. So that's why ZO is contraindicated as a base material below the composite restoration. Second, if you are used this as a temporary material and the next appointment if you are removing and placing the composite, it is found that there is some amount of eugenol which is remaining in tooth, and this will prevent the composite or bonding agent from attaining a high bond strength. So the take home message is that if you are doing a composite restoration, you can go for glass ionomer cement as a temporary restoration and then give a composite in the next appointment. The same concern is also present in veneer cementation. Suppose before giving a permanent cementation of veneering, you gave a temporary with zinc oxide eugenol cement. In future, the resin cement for permanent cementation will have a lesser bond, which is sometimes really damaging for the long-term health of the restoration. So what is the solution? Nowadays, in market, you have non-eugenol containing zinc oxide cements, which can be beneficial in such situation whenever a resin bonding material is involved. Coming to the last aspect, that what modifications are done in zinc oxide eugenol cement and why were they done? We already discussed the non-eugenol containing zinc oxide cement, but the second major change was in order to increase the strength. There are situations where you want to wait for more than 6 to 8 months before giving a permanent restoration. And in that situation, if you are giving the normal zinc oxide eugenol cement as a temporary, it will dissolve or it may break because it doesn't have sufficient strength. Although you can increase the strength by incorporating more powder into the cement liquid. However, if you have a zinc oxide eugenol modification with better strength, it will be really useful in this scenario. And in order to improve the strength, two types of modification were done. The first modification is popularly known as IRM, that is intermediate restorative material, in which the powder has additions of polymethacrylate, and this definitely increases the strength biocompatibility of the cement compared to the unmodified zinc oxide eugenol cement. However, please note that IRM is a bit difficult to remove than the zinc oxide eugenol cement. The second modification is popularly known as super EBA, in which the main aim of introducing this modification was to increase the strength but also to alter the setting time. This was modified by substituting the eugenol partially with orthoethoxybenzoic acid, and the powder also had quartz or aluminium oxide. Please note that super EBA is considered to be one of the best material for retrograde root filling. If this is your first time on Aspire 32, please consider subscribing and supporting me by sharing this video with your friends, and don't forget to click the like button if you found the video helpful. If you have any questions, please do write into the comment section, and I will see you once again with more videos on Aspire 32.